Over the last decade, there has been over 50 IPOs in Brazil across a number of different industries. And this trend has been fueled by both foreign and local Brazilian private equity firms. To discuss that and educate us about what's going on in Brazil, we invited Brett Rochkind. Where's Brett? Right here. Please, Brett, join me. Brett leads General Atlantic's Palo Alto office. He's co-head of the firm's internet and technology sector. He has invested in companies such as Smiles, XP Investments, Decolar.com, and BMF and Bovespa. It's great to have you here, Brett. Thank you. Let me pull your slides right here. And you can have this while I get your slides.
Sure, great. So also, that's quite an act to follow. So I'd ask you to bear with me. I guess I could talk about investing in pan de queso chains or fogo de chao, but I don't think that would go over well with Rory, and he could kick my ass a lot faster than I could, particularly since he's been following quite a good diet. Oh, excellent. Thanks very much. So let me first talk about a story about, and I'll try and keep this short because I think we have a panel right after this.
Questions to Brett will be during the panel.
So, just so I know the audience, how many of you have been to Brazil before or are Brazilian? Okay. And how many of you have not been to Brazil but really want to go? Okay, excellent. So that's where I was, I don't know, probably, I grew up in Maryland outside D.C., from when I was probably 5 years old and even knew about Brazil till my first trip in 2007. And the same for my wife. My wife's Israeli. When I first met her, her big thing was, we got to do our honeymoon in Brazil. We ended up deciding to get married in June. That's not a good time to go to Brazil, as many of you know. So we went to Asia instead. But my first trip to Brazil was in 2007. I flew down. I was in New York at the time. Flew down to Sao Paulo. People had kind of told me about Sao Paulo and kind of being the concrete jungle. They were right. But there's obviously a lovely park right in the middle that was nice to go for a little jog in. Went from company meeting to company meeting. What I found was so fascinating was, people start a little later, which was good because I'm a later person. But man, dinner started at 9 o'clock. We went through midnight, went beyond midnight. I mean, it was pretty unbelievable. And then I went from, this is kind of November 2007, then I went from Sao Paulo to Rio, flew into that amazing airport, best airport in the world. How many of you have taken that flight from Sao Paulo to Rio? I mean, that is just unbelievable. I mean, I wish my camera was good enough to take the photos from that. Ended up landing, it was a beautiful sunny day. And then actually I was supposed to fly back that night, but it started raining out of nowhere, which actually was great because then I got stuck in Rio overnight, which actually was much better to be stuck in than Sao Paulo, and had a wonderful evening in Rio out till very late. And then it came time to leave. And I was traveling with one of my partners at the time. As we talked about, concrete jungle, traffic is not one of the most positive aspects of Sao Paulo and of Brazil. And my partner was a little bit less patient than I was. And so we decided, it was about 4 hours before our flight started getting the road, and my partner wanted to take a helicopter. And I sat there and I was like, helicopter? Okay, that sounds great, but this is Brazil. I don't know about helicopters. I'm not following the Gracie diet, but I do want to live, quite a long period of time. And so, I ended up, we decided, to get on the road. Didn't move. It was during one of those national holidays. And we sat there and we ended up going to the side of the road, and literally our driver called up some random helicopter pilot. Literally, I guess there's helicopters everywhere, as you guys know. Ended up boarding a helicopter, flying all the way there, and the entire way, we were sitting in traffic, pulled over. The entire way, my partner sat there and said nasty words to me about how I had him sit in traffic for quite a while, how he went on this helicopter. As I was boarding the helicopter, I was texting my wife, I love you. I don't know if I'll make it, but I'll hopefully see you on the other side. Got in the airport, and lovely sat there for 4 hours in the airport in Sao Paulo and Guarulhos till our flight. Had lovely salami sandwiches. One of the arguments I made to my partner was that there's the best sushi places in the world. It's Apollo, so I could definitely justify taking the helicopter if we were going to go for a nice meal at a sushi restaurant and then ultimately get there. And to that day, my partner said, you know, I'm never going back to Brazil. And I said, that's great, because I am. And now it's been 24, 25 trips since 2007. As a firm, we've made 10 investments in Brazil, invested close to about $2 billion. And it's been awesome, and I love it. And I don't take helicopters anymore, so I'm allowed to. But you know, it's been great spending time there. Let me give you some quick background on General Atlantic, in case you just know. There's a little bit of marketing, so bear with me for 30 seconds. So we've basically been around for 33 years, managed about $18 billion. We write kind of $50 million to $500 million equity checks. You know, we invest across five sectors, so I co-head what we do in internet technology. We also do financial services, healthcare, business services, as well as consumer and retail, particularly in emerging markets, as well as a little bit here in the U.S. These are some of the companies that we've invested in: Box, Priceline, New York Stock Exchange, E-Trade, First Republic Bank. How many of you have a mortgage from First Republic Bank? Tory Burch was actually our largest investment last year for the ladies in the room. I can't offer discounts, so I apologize. Mercado Libre, which is an investment we made in Argentina, but very proud of what they've done in Brazil and in Latin America. Last year, we invested in Decolar. Hopefully, when you're booking your travel to Brazil, using Decolar. Bond, which is a software company out in the Netherlands. Axel Springer. We've got a great portfolio in China as well. And we basically invested in almost every continent out there. What if you ask people in the firm what continent we're most excited about, leaving currency aside for a moment, it's absolutely Latin America. And so we've invested quite a bit of resources in building our effort. We opened our office almost 10 years ago, made it more of an advisory office until 2007. We started really ramping up our efforts. We have about seven investment professionals today. In Sao Paulo, we've been very active looking at Mexico. We've made kind of 10 investments in the markets I mentioned, and we're looking actively at more. We think it's a great market for us because it's all about growth, entrepreneurship, founders. We love investing in founder-owned companies, and there's just dynamic growth across so many different sectors in Brazil, and that's really what we've gravitated to. And we make minority investments, we make majority investments, so we're very flexible as to how we invest. These are the companies we invested in, in Latin America specifically. I've been active in all of the internet technology companies. Actually, most recently, I don't know, how many of you are Smiles members? Smiles? Good. Excellent, we like that. We all used to be MultiPlus members, now we fly Gol, good or bad. And so we are big advocates of what's going on there and just great business models in the freaking flyer market. One of the companies, Lynx, any of you guys familiar with Lynx at all? It's a business that is really neat. I've spent a lot of time here. I had our Palo Alto office right in downtown there and in Silicon Valley. And I've looked all over the world in markets for software as a service kinds of business, cloud businesses, subscription term license businesses. And Lynx is all of that, but it's, and actually if you find in the US, a lot of those companies don't make any money. They basically, they burn through cash as they're building sales and marketing. They raise lots of venture capital. What I love about Lynx is it's all of those things, except they make 30% EBITDA margins. And they were a founder-owned company. We're the first, along with BNDS, we're the first two outside investors in the company. We ultimately just took that company public here in Brazil, and a lot of my friends in Brazil were really closely watching it because there haven't been that many IPOs in Brazil, and Lynx just went out a few months ago, and it's been very positively received. Stock's up almost 40%, and it's just a great case study for other technology companies in Brazil. We're hopeful our company, Mercado Libre is still kind of the main company in the e-commerce area, traded here in NASDAQ. We're hopeful Decolar will be kind of the next great Latin American and Brazilian internet company when it hopefully goes public in the next couple of years. What we love about Brazil is, all the things that you guys know, right? We think it's going to be the fourth largest economy in the world in, a matter of, a few decades from now. But we're long-term investors, been around 33 years, so we expect to be around even longer. And we love the fact that there's, you know, just a burgeoning middle class. You know, we all talk about C, D, and E consumers. Obviously, A and B consumers continue to keep growing, given, and we've found plays like Tory Burch's opening office, opening stores in Brazil and Latin America to play against kind of the higher net income folks. We can play that globally. And then we've been looking very actively at kind of C and B level classes, you know, consumer companies that really address that. We think in some ways Smiles, in some respect, is better place for kind of being a retail coalition program as opposed to just a freaking flyer program. And so we've been very active in looking at different companies and markets in there, including retailers and so forth. We basically are very thematic. So what we love is consumer spending, right? So we had investment in a company called Qualicorp, which was a leading private health insurance brokerage company. Ultimately, that company is now a public company in the Bovespa. And so we saw that, you know, if you look on the left side, just healthcare spending is continuing to grow. There's a private healthcare system. And so that's been a big theme we've been looking at in Brazil, you know, everything from drugstores, pharmacies, hospitals, all sorts of kind of privately oriented healthcare opportunities. We love consumer trends, and we've made a number of investments in financial services and asset management and all the things. Most recently, last year, in XP Investimentos, if you're familiar with that company, which is, we think it's more of an offline brokerage today, but we think there's aspects that we saw with E-Trade, you know, 10 years ago, 15 years ago, that we think we can bring to something like XP in terms of driving real innovation in the brokerage market. You know, internet, I think these are all the things that you know about. You know, we think, you know, obviously mobile penetration, smartphones, we're still in a very early stage of development in that market. You know, all of our companies, every board meeting for Decolar, we're talking about how much of their traffic is going through mobile phones and through smartphones, how much is on tablet. Clearly, you know, that's where the future is, both here and around the world. And so that's actively something that creates a real opportunity for Brazilian internet and technology companies, given they know the local nuances. They're building for the Android platform in most respects, and also for Apple and iOS. And we think that's going to be something that's going to continue to drive future opportunities. And the last, which we haven't really found a way to play, although, you know, I've joked a little bit with Harold about some of the things that we could maybe do in this area, is natural resources. And we think, you know, that clearly is a huge strength for Brazil. It's just a matter of time when we find an investment opportunity in that area. We've looked at agriculture, we've looked at sugar and ethanol-based technologies, and so we think that's a neat opportunity for us. And these are the investment themes. I won't go into, you know, that many specifics, because I've talked about kind of the three main ones we're going after. But that's what we're doing. That's our strategy.
Great. Thank you so much, Brett.